And welcome back again. I'm Duke of the Bump, and this is Dungeon Hack. We're on level 2. Corridors made of marble with what appears to be linoleum floor. Let's see, are we going to take damage if we step on that? Probably. Yeah, let's see what happens. Yes, a lot of damage. Ow, that hurt. But there's no other way to go. I had to do it. I hate the zombie noise. So I watched the movie I Am Legend with those zombie vampires or whatever they were supposed to be. I thought it was a pretty decent flick. I was a little disappointed with how cartoony the monsters looked. I mean, they would have been, you know, fairly intimidating if they weren't so freaking obviously CGI. But it was a good performance by Will Smith. I don't normally like the sort of things that he does, but he was okay in that movie. And we already have one page of our inventory full. This is one of the shrines I was talking about. If I was low on health, then I could put a coin in that slot and it would patch me right up. I actually think there's one in, like, my second video that I just walked right past. I love sneaking up on them. It makes me feel so sneaky. No secret illusionary walls there. I found a rock. You can throw stuff at enemies, too. Like, I just hit that zombie with a rock. How do I open this door? It says it won't budge. Is there a switch around here? I guess not. It's probably one of those doors that can only be opened from one side. Oh well. Let's carry on, my wayward son. Well, that's a pretty disappointing dead end. Let's see. I guess we just need to... You know what? Let's use our Amulet of Imminent Return and go back to... Well, technically it's the end of the previous level, but once we go back down these stairs, we'll be a lot closer to the next way we want to go. Whoa, zombie. I don't take kindly to brain eaters. Sorry, but my brains belong firmly in my skull. Come on, wusses. Pretty much no reasoning with the monsters in this game. You're not going to talk your way out of it or make them run away. They just blindly attack until they're dead. Now in the actual D&D rules, monsters have a stat called morale, and based on how many of them there are and how much damage they've taken, it causes them to run away in certain circumstances. But, not in this game. Oh, another potion of monster detection. I don't really see a situation in which I'm really going to need something like that, but I'll hang on to it. Man, the art for these zombies look terrible. They look like they're just wearing a bad sweatsuit. Remember, kids, if you find an apple laying around on the floor of some old forgotten dungeon, eat it. Eat it! Eat the apple. A gray potion. Let's see what that one does. Burnt my tongue to a crisp. Wow. That's an awesome potion. I want to throw it at a monster. See what happens. See if they burst into flame. Maybe it's like holy water. Holy water is supposed to burn, isn't it? That's how it seems to be in Castlevania, anyway. God, why does it take so long to load your game? It doesn't take that long to restore it. Or to save it, rather. Well, I hit him with it. It wasn't that helpful, but it did some damage. Let's see, where to now? Can I open that door all the way to the left? I forget. Yep. Haven't been here yet. Alright. Cleric level 5. It gives me 9 additional hit points. For a total of 33, and it also gives us some more spells. We have one more level 1, or one more level 2 spell available to us. I guess I'll just get another Flame Blade for now. Well, I'll show out this other spell. It's called Spiritual Hammer, and we have level 3 spells available. The most important one here is Create Food and Water. This will make sure that we never, ever starve to death. This is pretty much the only reason I play a cleric in this game, because starving to death is the worst way to die. We also have protection from fire, remove paralysis, which is really useless in this game since there's only one character that you play, and if you're paralyzed, you can't cast spells. Remove curse, that'll be handy, it'll make it so I don't have to save my game every time I try a new item on. And water breathing. Don't remember if that's useful or not. I think there are water sections late in the game, but for now, we will just get, a couple of those. Oh, it won't let me rest because there's monsters around. Here, monsters, monsters, monsters. Here, lizard, lizard, lizard. Ow! You bastard. Hold on. Sorry about that. I had some unexpected company drop by, and I tried to pause the recording without closing the freaking game, but didn't work out, so I'm going to have to load my last save. And I forget how long ago that was. I don't think it was too long, thankfully. Another 10-minute wait while we load my game. Maybe I should have just stopped it there. Come on, restore LP already. Okay, where am I? Am I level 5? No. Come on. Why isn't my number pad working? There we go. I gotta be pretty close. I'm just going to level up again and then, well, I don't know. Maybe I can level up before the video's over. Uh, I didn't think I'd be having anybody stop by today, so. It doesn't tell you how many experience points you need, so I really have no way of judging. Oh, no wonder it's so slow. I forgot to increase the CPU cycles again. Son of a... Come on, let me go up a level. I have 30 seconds left. Alright, cleric level 5. Alright, that about does it for this edition of Dungeon Hack. See you guys next time.